packing bangers to make a host out of clothes hangers. It's only one life to give in. Get in where you fit in. The fofo will go push your shit in. So keep your gun greased. We're fucking with these New York desperados. We'll bust open your heads like avocados. Heavy artillery in my facility. For you snake ass ones, I stick to my guns.
Yo, what up?
Ain't nothing.
Is it real?
Yeah, son.
What's today's mathematics? This
stick to your guns.
What's the word?
Ain't nothing.
Is it real?
Yeah, son.
What's today's knowledge to sell?
Stick
your
to
most
your
beautiful
guns.
Thing in the world is a fofo desert eagle.
Nigga,
that shit is beast.
Leap through hollow points, lunch, plunge through any object. Squeeze it, I rap it, fire, clear the whole project. I ain't gonna be beefing eye in you. Silently, I move. I've been chasing and lacing tough guys for days. Finding ways to erase them and place them in a grave. If it happened, it's flaws capping. I'm in the mix and I'd rather be judged by 12 than laid by 6. My God, on the front line, still standing. Mr. Billy Dan's and I'm working with a mini cannon. Holding it down, it's a drama lord. So you riff, you'll be lifting like stiff as a fucking board. Fire is flawed,
yeah.
Niggas on the run, get props from top knots. Niggas the hell, bail, stick to
it.
Since Queens on crime scenes, a murder machine. Put M16s in niggas' fleas. I head for the hills, niggas, cause when I get ill, it's blood spill for real. I aim a fucking steel and shoot the kill. So grab your body shield, get ready for the ducking. The biscuit that I'm clutching, punching like Dutchman, that's the fucking Dutchman. Bucking at all you sucker clucking niggas that want the ruckus. You'll be three niggas clapping, but we ain't applauding you motherfuckers. Keep my neck head up on the black t-shirts to grab lens. Ain't gotta go rush the Toys R Us to get your cabbage basket. Once I let the laser beams gleam in the red dots.
Oh, hey there, everyone. Didn't see you there. But I'm assuming you all came here today to further educate yourself on the douche. The douche is a very rapidly breeding creature that has grown out of control, but we still don't know much about it. So we've decided to further educate ourselves and throw everyday kids like you off the streets into real-world situations. Let's go.
So, tell us, why you think you're fit for this job?
What job? What is this?
Douche.
Oh. I think I would be very fit for being the douche, because I'm not very douchey right now, and I think that I have room for improvement. I'd be fit for this job because, well, number one, I'm pretty pretty, and in my outfit, I'm not really good. I'm not a douche, and I have room to improve and become more of a douche, and that is why I'd be fit for this job. I'm a good listening, and I can take your instructions, and I'll do pretty much anything you say. I'll do anything you say, and so I'll be good for this. Yes.
The douche, a fascinating creature and an intellectually inferior alpha male who is always on the hunt for hoes with fat asses. His intentions are few, but he follows a strict and abundant amount of rules. The biggest concern for a douche is his appearance. You can see their careful and meticulous mindset from their clothes, self-pampering, and style. As you may see here, this is a fine example of what a douche isn't. Notice his clothing and lack of self-grooming. Let's start with clothing. A douche has a very precise sense of style and appearance. He wishes to display focusing on brand name clothing with many douche symbols and obvious douche signs. For example, crosses. Let's go see how Luke is doing. Look at our specimen here, Luke. Although he doesn't really look like he knows what he's doing, or probably where he's at, he does look indeed like his mom dresses him every day. And that is what we're trying to fix. We're trying to make him look like a douche. See his goofy looking clothes and flannel shirt. It's purple and blue, and buttons are unbuttoned way too far, and now he's just showing off his chest. He's got a decent start though. He does not have any chest hair. And he just has perfect pecs. Not really. He just looks like a tool. Now that we've established Luke looks like a giant tool and that his mom dresses him, let's see if we can try one more time to make him look more of a douche. Excellent. An extraordinary example of douche style. Now moving on to grooming. Notice our specimen's almost feminine-like attention to personal grooming. Notice how cleanly shaved his body is, and that muscle definition. God, Luke Supancic has the biggest biceps I have ever seen. And he doesn't have a chest hair in sight either. The only hair that should be paid attention to are the eyebrows and a douche's haircut. Did you notice the way he walks and his distinct dialect? These are few of the many things that make up a douche, but now we're going to work on his swag. Let's see how Luke walks. Good, but not douchey enough. He just looks like a total white tool.
Put him back.
Step 1. Don't walk so stuck up. Let loose. The douche will not give no shits. Step 2. Firmly grip your manly parts with one hand. This symbolizes your aggressive nature and that you are confident with yourself and body.
Should I start holding the balls?
Yeah, go ahead. Yeah, step 3. Step 3. Specimens should have slight BO, the natural musk of a bro, and have a scent of alcohol from the breath. Douches should always be slightly tipsy to reach maximum douche and be free of inhibitions. One must also be covered from head to toe in Hollister cologne. A douche will indeed smell like the store, mixed with the other scents listed above. Now let's see if he can walk like a douche. Play like a true douche. Now that you walk, look, and act like one, let's move on.
I think I'm gonna go have a shower.
Next is the desired woman the douche wants to mate with, or hoe to hook up with. Notice the scantily clad woman. They are sporting a multitude of piercings and tattoos. A sure sign of a douche-friendly female is a tattoo located on the lower back, commonly referred to as a tramp stamp. Women with those sure signs are most likely to be known as thirsty and down to party. Now let's see how Luke and the females mingle.
What's up, sluts?
Notice how similar their mannerisms are, their interests and looks as well. The douche and hoe are very tan, well-groomed, and in heavy amounts of makeup for the hoe. Now see Luke here, cruising into hood. But there's one problem. His vehicle is empty, and he's looking for hot young bitches to score with. I think Luke sees some over there. Let's see how he interacts.
Hey girl, you look nice, intelligent, and pretty. Would you mind accompanying me on this fine evening?
Well, no thanks.
Now let's back up and see how a true douche should do it.
Man. Get the fuck in the car! Hey girls, you look like a parking ticket. You look like you'll cost me $100 tonight.
Good, well let's try one more time.
I'm just gonna say.
Hey ladies, you look like you need a real man. Hop my ride and we can hit up the club and get shit-faced.
Okay!
Oh my god!
Spoken like a true douche. Lucas found his hose, but he needs to find proper transportation.
Great! I feel like such a bro.
Hold on now, boyo. You're still only about halfway there.
What do you mean? I've got these terrific clothes and some hose. What else do I need?
You're getting there. The next step in becoming a douchebag is having a hot ride. Show me your wheels.
These are my wheels. You like them?
Are you kidding me? What are you, a soccer mom?
No! This is a 2011 Honda Odyssey. How can you say that?
Okay, if you'd rather pick up your kids from kindergarten than be a douche, I guess you could keep it.
Man, this thing picks up hoes.
Having a nice car is actually a common mistake. Why would a real douche want a car so new it still has that one-of-a-kind smell, shiny with not one dirt stain or scratch? Then he would not be able to be reckless, and all the ladies would be more prone to shaking him off. Now, even though your ride should be old with a few dents and scratches, maybe a cracked windshield when you're not driving it, you should treat it like a newborn baby. This brings us to the next step in becoming a douche, having the same chill daily routine most douches have.
Get out of the car and like flash gang signs.
Get out of the car and flash gang signs? What do you mean by flash gang signs? It's harder than it looks. This is the only gang sign I know. Oh, I can do blood.
Just get out and do it.
Alright. Wait, is the car on or we dump it?
We're done.
You gonna see what this D can do for you?
Yeah, but I have this creepy ex-husband you're gonna have to get rid of first.
Oh, that's no problem. I'll cap that mother lover.
Then what?
Then I'm gonna take out the gun and shoot him in the face. Nah, that's not part of the video. But I am gonna take out the gun and shoot him in the face.
Okay, well then you just say that.
What's up, punk ass?
I'll kill you.
No, beat shit out of you.
I'll kill you. No.
Hell yeah. Hell yeah.
You have the right to remain silent. You're innocent until proven guilty in the court of law.
Convict 163, please.
There's actually a squirrel on my deck.
God damn it. Okay, let's try it again.
That squirrel just fucking jumped after a bird.
Oh my god.
Okay, I don't need. Nah, yes, I do. I don't need.
Next is the desired woman of the douche wants to mate with, or hoe to hook up with. Notice the scantily clad woman. They are sporting a multitude of piercings and tattoos. A sure sign of a douche-friendly female is a tattoo located on the lower back, commonly referred to... God damn it.
Shit! I wanted to show it to her.
You guys are stupid.
When he says... Right,
so funny. Look at this. Two fireplaces.
That's awesome. I don't know how to...
Hi.
I'm just gonna be like, come here, baby. I'm just kidding.
I have that on camera.